Me, but also you. The Pharaoh fast-forwards his favorite foreign film, Powder Donut. Okay, what's my line?
The only line I see here on the script is get options based on your budget with the name and price tool from Progressive.
Oh man, that's a tongue twister, huh? I'm sorry, I'm gonna need a few more minutes. Bulbous Walrus, the Bulbous Walrus.
The name your price tool, only from Progressive.
The owl ran afoul of the comatose coxswain.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Let's get it started in here.
It's morning again, and waking up isn't easy. At least I know my favorite show is on. It's 6 a.m. There ain't nobody like them. I just know they'll never steer me wrong. Sam, John, Drew, and Sam, speaking out, talking to me, talking to you. Justice and Drew, mornings have never been so good. And Drew, I never miss a show. I don't think I could.
Then I look at you.
Can you dig it?
And the world's all right with me.
Can you dig it?
Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be.
Can you dig it?
103.5 FM. Good morning. It is Tuesday, May 4th, 2021, and this is Justice and Drew. My name is Drew, and that guy's name is John Justice.
Hey, that's me.
Impressively clad in much Star Wars.
Yeah, I didn't put any thought into that at all.
No.
Didn't tweet
about it yesterday.
Didn't have.
Yeah. I'm sad you didn't take my suggestion.
Didn't have multiple options.
I was pretty pleased with my offering when you were making the plea for help on what to wear for Star Wars Day.
Yeah.
May the 4th be with you.
Yeah, may the 4th be with you as well. Thank you, Sam.
Live long and prosper.
Appreciate that, yeah.
Yes.
Well, and Drew tweeted out a picture of a yellow Star Trek shirt.
Wait, what?
To which I'm not going to lie, I got a little concerned. Because I was like, man, you know, I know that it would all be in good fun if my fellow coworkers came in wearing Star Trek stuff.
I already decided.
You might.
Yeah, I did. And I was like, well, I'm just to dig deep, just accept it if it happens and let it not show that it would bother me.
If I owned Star Trek things, I would wear them. So in honor of
I really wish I had now.
I know, I do too.
I really wish I hadn't said that now.
In honor of May the 4th be with you, I'm well equipped with Star Trek facts.
Awesome. it's pretty cool because this was something that the fans just did because it was May the 4th, and you know, May was traditionally sort of within the Star Wars fandom kind of considered Star Wars month because that's when all the original movies were released.
Were they?
May 25th was the release, 1977 of the first one. So throughout the years, like May the 4th, just because of the play on words, and I don't want to say one of the best things, but I think for a lot of people, one of the best things that's come out of Disney's acquisition of Star Wars was that they decided to actually make it the official day.
Right.
So there's a lot of expectations. Like Marvel dropped a ton of stuff yesterday, which I kind of felt like was kind of clearing a path because Disney knew that they had a lot of Star Wars stuff to talk about today. So it's fun.
Yeah. Well, happy May the 4th, everybody.
Yeah. I had a couple of different shirts I was going to wear, and then I landed on Force Awakens stuff.
Well, you look great.
Well, I'll share the photo. Just a really stupid story because I'm an idiot and weird. I have a...
Get that drop.
Yes, please do. It's worthy.
I have a I have kind of a retro Star Wars shirt, and it has a, like a really old school photo of you know, from a still from the promotion of the original movie of R2-D2 and C-3PO.
I love the retro artwork and
right.
retro posters. Those
I
are
do
my
too.
Favorites.
The racetrack logo is just the, it's the best, and that's what it is. It's R2 and 3PO with the racetrack logo and the Star Wars logo and all that. So I was going to wear that today, and I was like, that's old school, right? Mm-hmm. Well, I'll tweet the picture out. I threw it on my bed. Did I snap the photo? And then I realized that the print is completely off center and to the side. I never noticed it before. And I was like, and then suddenly, like, my head could not move. I couldn't move past it.
I can't put that on.
I couldn't move past the fact that the logo is completely before we get into Sam's top five, just because it's that stupid. And nobody would have noticed. Nobody would have ever, neither of you would have looked at me and goes, that shirt's pretty cool, but you know what? That that graphic image is completely off center. Nobody would have said that, but
nobody,
you know what?
Noticed.
Up here? Underneath the Star Wars hat?
Yeah.
I would have known.
It just bothered you all day.
Yeah, absolutely.
What are you going to do with that shirt now?
You know, I'll just still wear it, just not on official occasions.
Okay. Maybe just around the house.
Yeah, exactly.
Around the house shirt.
Yeah. Turn it into a jammy shirt or something.
We got a pretty full show for you today. We've got Senate Majority Leader Paul Gazelka coming on at 7:35 this morning. The Minnesota Senate passed a voter ID bill yesterday. It's a worthy bill. Unfortunately, it probably isn't going to go anywhere.
No.
But we'll get his thoughts on that. We've got Pete Hegseth from Fox News coming on at 8:35 this morning.
At 8 o'clock, you definitely want to be here at 8 o'clock. We talked about this. This is so far the only juror in the Derek Chauvin trial who's been making public statements.
There was the one alternate.
The one alternate, but this is the only actual one, right?
Yes.
That
I've seen anyway.
This particular juror is is continuing to go down the path of making statements and talking to anybody and everybody he possibly can.
Yeah, this dude wants to be famous.
And
for sure.
The comments that he is making, Drew, I don't want to steal your, because I hadn't thought about it until you sent the prep over, but man,
he's giving I'll just say this. I've reached out. I've sent out the bat signal for lawyer extraordinaire Jeff O'Brien to get his thoughts as well, coming up in the 7:55 segment. But he's given the Chauvin team a lot of ammunition for an appeal.
Yeah.
Lot of ammunition for an appeal. And it sounds to me, you piece these statements together because they're coming from different sources.
Many different sources.
And they're on different topics. So it's not like the same story sort of getting reprinted or the same interview, you know, excerpts are being pulled from. It's not that at all. These are totally different stories. He keeps popping up in them. And it really sounds like he just wants to be famous. He wanted to get on this jury. He probably said whatever he needed to say to get selected onto the jury, and he did it with one goal in mind: convict Chauvin and then go get famous.
He has an anti-Minneapolis police department attitude and background. Several comments to make. He protested in Washington, D.C., mm-hmm. wearing, you know, get your knee off my neck T-shirts. You know, and it was funny because I asked Drew, I was like, how would he get on the jury? And you were like, and then I'm so like, you're going to be honest, right? Well, apparently he wasn't, because I don't know if he was honest. I have no idea how he would have been picked to be on the jury.
Yeah, and I haven't certainly gone back and dug through his questionnaires or anything or his testimony to
maybe he was that honest and.
Well, you know, you can be honest and still not tell
sure.
the whole truth.
Sure.
Right? I mean, you know, you can live up to the terms of an oath that you take when you're taking the stand, but still lie by omission.
Right. So we will dive into that at 8 o'clock. We do have Sam's Top 5 coming up. Before we get into Sam's Top 5, we have an update on a story that we covered yesterday. The Snow White ride that got the publication in San Francisco upset because the ending wasn't woke. It's now conservatives' fault.
Oh, yeah, Republicans pounce.
Yeah, yeah, it's conservatives. Yeah. It's the conservatives' fault for getting upset that somebody else was upset over the ending, the new ending to the ride.
Yes, conservatives have once again pounced.
Twin Cities News Talk has your chance to win.
Me, but also you. The Pharaoh fast forwards his favorite foreign film, Powder Donut. Okay, what's my line?
The only line I see here on the script is get options based on your budget with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive.
Oh, man. That's a tongue twister, huh? I'm sorry. I'm going to need a few more minutes. Bulbous Walrus. The Bulbous Walrus.
The Name Your Price tool. Only from Progressive.
The owl ran afoul of the comatose coxswain.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Introducing touch-free payments from PayPal. A safe way for your customers to pay. Simply download the PayPal app and display your own unique QR code for your customers to scan. Whether you're a market seller,
I'll take two tomatoes and a cucumber.
Poodle pamperer, piano tuner, or plumber. Signing up to accept touch-free payments for your business is easy. Touch-free QR code payments. Shop safe with PayPal.
Justice and Drew, Twin Cities News Talk, AM 1130, 103.5 FM. Happy to see that the company that provides us paychecks is celebrating Star Wars Day.
Yeah, May the 4th day on the iHeartRadio app.
It's pretty awesome.
That's cool. May the 4th radio.
Love
it's,
it.
It's transcended.
Is it just the Creature Cantina theme on loop?
If it is, I don't care.
It's good enough for me.
Yeah, it's works for me. So before we dive into Sam's Top 5 here on Twin Cities News Talk, we talked about this yesterday. Daily Wire reported this. It was in the San Francisco Gate, right? The managing editor for the San Francisco Gate, a website launched by the San Francisco Chronicle, wrote a review of Disneyland's recently updated Snow White ride alongside with Julie Tremaine. Though the review was mostly positive, the two felt it was entirely necessary to criticize the ride for featuring the iconic scene in which the prince awakens Snow White from her eternal sleep by way of a kiss. And in their critique, they say, right, Snow White, asleep under the Evil Queen's spell, gives her the true love's kiss to release her from the enchantment. A kiss that he gives without her consent while she's asleep, which can't possibly be true love if only one person knows it's happening.
Yeah, it's called a fairy tale.
Right.
Yeah, also had these was this the first time these people had seen this Snow White scene? Had they never seen the movie?
No familiarity with it whatsoever. Have they never seen a Disney princess movie?
Right?
Because they like all end that way.
They probably were going through the ride or whatever it is, however they did this, and were like, what? Who doesn't know the story of Snow White?
This is the line we landed on yesterday. Haven't we already agreed that consent in early Disney movies is a major issue? Like, no, we didn't. No,
you might have.
You may have, but
we didn't.
I have literally never thought about that.
So, as par for the course these days, rather than mock the San Francisco Gate for publishing a ridiculous paragraph that criticized the revamped Snow White ride at Disneyland, leftists over at the Daily Beast and on Twitter chose to instead mock conservative media for allegedly manufacturing outrage as part of its continued quest to fight the phantom enemy known as cancel culture.
Mm.
What?
Yeah, it's all conservatives' fault for.
Yeah.
So you make a controversial statement, talk about how it's not woke enough for you, and then when you receive backlash for it, it's the person who's responding to it that's the problem.
That's always the way, though. It's never what liberals do. It's never what Democrats do. It's never their actions that are the problem. It's always the conservative reaction that makes the news.
Fox News finds its dumb new outrage. Woke mob is canceling a Snow White theme park ride, headlined the Daily Beast. Transgender activist Charlotte Clymer tweeted, people need to stop writing think pieces like the Snow White articles so that conservatives don't weaponize them as consequences of cancel culture. Listen, they're going to find something to get angry about regardless. Anger is the point.
Has this person not watched liberals for the last 4 years?
Oh my gosh.
Did they not pay attention to anything liberals did during the Trump administration?
Oh my God.
Talk about manufactured, fabricated outrage.
They'll fabricate outrage if needed. That's the whole thrust of all of this. It's their entire strategy for 2022. Pretend everything you know and love in America is under attack by liberals.
It is!
Endlessly cover it in right-wing media.
We need to!
Fundraise and campaign on it.
We also need to do that.
That's the whole vision. The disconnect here is astonishing.
Yeah. I mean, that's, look, and you can fairly say that about some aspects of conservative media.
Sure.
That is, that's the game that both sides play. Get your side all ginned up and outraged and angry and then start fundraising.
Yeah, they're allowed to do it.
Yeah, sign up for any DFL or fundraiser letters. I swear, just sign up for any of them. Go to their website and put in a, you know, set up a fake email address and have it forwarded to your real one, whatever, you know, just, and you'll see every time they're something, anything. Trump sends out one of his little statements now that he, you know, has to do instead of because he's not allowed to tweet anymore. And you will get 15 fundraising emails within 15 minutes.
Yeah, Trump is all up in my emails.
Yeah, he was chatty yesterday.
He was.
I got to get a new like sounder like Trump emails.
They're basically, a lot of them are basically tweet length too.
Well, I hear that apparently Facebook is supposed to be deciding this week whether or not they're going to allow him back on. And I can't help but think it's just because they need more individuals to go back to Facebook.
Yep. For sure. Yep. Yeah, 100%.
One more quick point on this so we can dive into Sam's top five. And it cracks me up because what the Daily Beast and Charlotte don't realize is that you've just exposed how much you don't really care about the end of that ride. If you really did, if you really did care, and the writers for that article really did care about the ending of that, if it was a genuine reaction that they really genuinely felt that the lack of a consensual true love's kiss was damaging to children, you would continue to talk about that. You would go and it was like, well, you know, conservatives obviously don't care when it comes to, you know, being consensual, because this is a big deal. But no, instead of doing that, they just go, oh, look at them. They're just trying to gin up outrage again. You've just proven that you're being completely inauthentic in your outrage.
Right. And look, commenting on something and calling it stupid is not outrage. Right. You know, that happens all the time. Like, I'll send a tweet out, or whatever it is. I'll send a tweet out about something, but like, this is dumb. Oh, another day of outrage. Oh, look at you, just angry. I'm not angry at all. I just said that was dumb.
Yeah.
It was stupid. The same thing with the Snow White. I'm not angry about Snow White. I'm not angry that
it's ridiculous.
Yeah, I think it's dumb. I'm mocking it. I'm not outraged.
We're just finding joy in the little things.
Fox News probably spent all of about 4 minutes in their 24-hour news cycle on it yesterday morning, but that's all it took, right? You know, you get one screenshot of Chiron, and it's like, you can say, this is all they talked about for 7 hours.
It was a breaking news alert.
Well, it might have been. They do that for anything.
Over at the BS Factory.
But stories about this were written in Entertainment Weekly, The Sun, The New York Post, The Daily Mail, Inside the Magic. I mean, these are not all, like, you know, hardcore conservative outlets.
No, and like we said yesterday, you know, Disney only has themselves to blame. They have changed their rides before. Mm-hmm. They changed the Jungle Cruise. They changed Pirates of the Caribbean, the greatest ride at Disneyland. Shh, be quiet over there, Drew.
It's terrible.
No.
It's an awful ride.
All right. I think now I think we're behind.
We are. We're very late. We'll jump into Sam's top five next.
Me, but also you. The Pharaoh fast forwards his favorite foreign film. Powder donut. Okay, what's my line?
The only line I see here on the script is get options based on your budget with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive.
Oh man, that's a tongue twister, huh? I'm sorry, I'm going to need a few more minutes. Bulbous Walrus, the Bulbous Walrus.
The Name Your Price tool, only from Progressive.
The owl ran afoul of the comatose coxswain.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Introducing touch-free payments from PayPal, a safe way for your customers to pay. Simply download the PayPal app and display your own unique QR code for your customers to scan. Whether you're a market seller,
I'll take two tomatoes and a cucumber.
Poodle pamperer, piano tuner, or plumber. Signing up to accept touch-free payments for your business is easy. Touch-free QR code payments. Shop safe with PayPal.
Can't hear this without thinking of Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yep.
Same.
Justice and Drew. On Twin Cities News Talk, AM 1130 and 103.5
great sound.
FM.
Such a good soundtrack.
Yeah.
1 hour from now, Senate Majority Leader Paul Gazelka will join us. We'll talk a little voter ID. I hear it's the new Jim Crow.
Yes. Totally.
And Lynx is laughing because it's so not.
It's so dumb.
Did you hear, by the way, I haven't even talked about this, did you hear that they put off the real ID nationally again?
I hadn't heard that, but I can't say I'm surprised.
Yeah, I can't either, but I just...
The rollout of this thing is what? It's like 20 years in the making before... We're totally going to do this, guys.
Yeah, it's going to happen. Yeah.
Really, you better get your real ID soon, because it's happening any day now.
Well, they need to add the COVID passport part of it to it.
Oh, that's right. Get your vaccine passport.
Exactly. I will say on my second dose, the nurse did say, hang on to your card. She did tell me.
Did she?
That. Yeah. Yeah.
For what?
She didn't say. She just said you should hang on to that. And I was like, no, okay. So it's in my glove box.
Yeah.
Where things go to never be seen again.
Right.
Along with the manual for the car and a lot of face masks.
Right. Oh, which hopefully will just die there as well.
Yes, exactly.
Let's jump into Sam's top five for a Tuesday.
Number one.
Florida's governor says he's suspending all local emergency orders related to the COVID-19 pandemic effective immediately.
Man, he is a great man.
Yeah. I saw an article saying that the most consequential and important Republican victory of like the last 20 years was DeSantis over Gillum.
Wow.
In 2018.
Yeah.
It's a pretty bold take, but I could get on board with it.
At this point, imagine where Florida would be if DeSantis wasn't governor.
Yeah.
I mean, it would be just another
poorly run liberal state.
Yep. But now they are a bastion of freedom.
Yeah, Governor Tim Walz, we know you're listening.
This is
what a real leader does,
yep.
And this is the courageous thing to do. What you're doing is cowardice. This is how you do the right thing, even though a lot of people may not like it. Right. This is the right thing to do.
During a news conference in St. Petersburg on Monday, Governor Ron DeSantis signed an executive order that suspends all local coronavirus mandates in Florida right away and will also invalidate all remaining local emergency COVID-19 orders effective July 1st.
This doesn't stop anybody from continuing to live like they want to, wear face masks, socially distance. You know, you can continue to do all of those things without a government mandate, and businesses can continue to say, please wear a face mask upon entering. Please, businesses can continue to separate their tables, a socially distance, 6 feet, 3 feet, whatever you want to use. They can continue to, none of those things have to stop just because the government isn't mandating them anymore. And I feel like nobody really gets that. Like just because the government mandates something doesn't mandate something doesn't mean you're not allowed to do it.
That's what freedom gives you, man.
Yeah, exactly. Personal choice, personal responsibility.
Number two.
The COVID-19 pandemic helped fuel a 27% increase in drug overdose deaths in Minnesota last year.
The untold consequences.
Yeah, man, that's just tragic.
Overdose fatalities reached over 1,000 people in 2020, with the first large increase coming in March as the state saw its first coronavirus cases and deaths. The onset of a previously unknown virus that had already taken many lives across the world did lead many treatment and outreach resources to abruptly shut down, which really limited access for people who needed help.
And I take issue with the way that sentence is phrased and written. The government led to many treatment and outreach resources to abruptly shut down. Not the virus.
No.
Not the pandemic. Not, that was the pretext in which the government made all of these decisions and forced so many of these centers to shut down.
We always had ways to protect ourselves since the start of this whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
We did. I mean, and it would, and even sort of walking into the wilderness, not knowing what you're going to expect, of which we all did at the beginning. We still knew that if you worked hard enough, you could protect yourself from this, but it just didn't matter.
Yeah, drug-related deaths increased 64% in March 2020 compared to the previous year, and then peaked at over 100 fatalities in the months of May and August.
And this should be even more infuriating for people out there, knowing what we know now. I mean, I can give people a pass for, in March of 2020 for, not being sure and not being, being afraid, because we didn't know a lot about this virus, and the things that we were hearing were, frankly, kind of terrifying, right? But what we know now, and especially what we know now about the government's incompetence incompetence and bungling of the response and how little they're actually relying on things like science and data to make these decisions, and it's more political calculations. This 27% increase in drug overdose deaths was entirely preventable.
And this isn't over yet either. This is the part of it that I find that's so troublesome, and it doesn't get talked about, is that there's a lot of people who we know they had to forego procedures. Mm. They had to forego preventative care. You know, you can't, you know, I did, you know, meetings with my cardiologist via Zoom. Okay. I'm fine, doc. Whatever, you know.
Yeah.
What is that? But my point is, there's going to be a lot of individuals who are going to be dealing with issues that have gotten and will be way worse than they would have been. And unfortunately, that in turn is going to require more individuals to have to take prescription pain medication, which is only going to exacerbate the problem.
Number three.
Aaron Rodgers has been given a cheesy offer to stay with the Packers, but there is one caveat.
It's real quick, but so you know what? I never liked the Packers. I've talked about this before. I've had this weird thing where every place that I've worked, apart from here, thankfully, mm-hmm. you know, I've just had Packer fans that have followed me around at every single radio job, including working for a company that was owned by a former Packer.
Yep.
Aaron Rodgers, I know he's a great quarterback, never really cared. I am oddly fascinated by this whole thing. This whole Aaron Rodgers wanting to leave the Packers and all of this. I'm like, give me the Netflix story right. When this thing is done.
I want the 30 Please. For 30
yes.
or whatever. I want the document. I want to know exactly yes. what is pissing Aaron Rodgers
straight
off
into
so
my
much.
Veins.
Because he might be right. Like, he might be completely justified in wanting to leave the Packers. I don't know, because I don't know these people, but it all sounds very personal.
Yes,
you know, it sounds like he's having
very
personal feuds with specific people in the front office, and I want to know those stories.
Well, even if
give me the drama.
Even if it's just a matter of, you know, he's been with the team for so long, let's just say, just for the sake of argument, maybe it's just a matter of, I've been here for so long, saw what Tom Brady did and was like, you know what? I want to change of pace.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, as fans, you know, of the NFL or the Packers, you're sitting back going, why would you do that? It's like, well, he's his own person, man. He's just like, I'm tired of green.
Maybe. maybe he's.
Lambeau's a dump. Oh, God, I'm going to get.
Oh, no.
I'm kidding.
That's pretending out to be there now. Robert. Oh, no.
I'm in trouble.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
I got to get those barricades up on my Drudasack real quick.
Maybe he just wanted some warmer weather. Maybe he's sick of playing outside.
I know, right?
Maybe he's like, I could play in air conditioning.
You know what? My head canon on Aaron Rodgers is that this has a lot to do with Tom Brady.
I can totally see it.
That's what my head canon is. My head canon is he's like, you know, he left in not even warmer climates. Just like, you know, he's going to
win him on the Super Bowl.
Different uniform. Right. Look at who he's able to do. A new challenge.
Yes, exactly.
Aaron Rodgers. Yeah, he might be totally sick of green and gold.
Yeah,
he might just hate it.
He might. I don't know. I mean, you know, there's obviously a lot going on here. But the one thing I keep coming back to is if Aaron Rodgers really felt like this Green Bay team that they're assembling right now was a Super Bowl contender, I don't think none of this would be happening. Like if he felt really good about his chances of winning a Super Bowl in this upcoming season or even the next season with the Packers, I don't think any of this would be coming up. But I think that's got to be at the core of it, is he's really frustrated with the decisions that have been made for the team around him and not giving him the pieces he feels like he needs to go out there and win a championship.
You'll know better than I do. We have far fewer legacy franchise quarterbacks than we do quarterbacks that shuffle around, right? Like the first thing that pops into my head is like Ben Roethlisberger.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm a casual, you know, NFL fan beyond what PA teaches me during the football season. But beyond that, I can't really think of anybody else.
Ben Roethlisberger, Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady, Drew Brees.
Okay, Drew Brees,
those
right.
Those would be, I think, your big four.
Mahomes may be heading
Mahomes
that direction.
Could be there.
Could be there at some point.
Russell Wilson could be there.
Okay.
He's won a couple of Super Bowls. You know, he hasn't played great these last couple seasons, but he still has, you know, he's got rings, and that's what you look for, right?
Yeah.
Rings. And he's a very good quarterback. But beyond that, you know, unless I'm just blanking on somebody, I think those four, that's your big four. And Ben's retired, so.
You just wonder, and again, we're white. Well, that list just shrunk.
Just shrunk by half.
Use the hashtag TCNT. But I, you know, you wonder. We should get, you know, we should really reach back out to PA once he's back from Barbados or wherever, and have him and come on, because I'd love to pick his brain on this, just to see what he thinks of Aaron Rodgers, but also whether or not, and maybe I'm making too big of a deal on this, if this is going to sort of maybe become a thing. You know, if a Russell Wilson sees this and is like, you know what? Mm-hmm. We've got other opportunities now, and how much did COVID play into this?
Correct, yeah. Yeah, you don't know.
Yeah.
You don't know. We'll continue with the story. We'll tell you about the cheesy offer that Aaron Rodgers has gotten.
Oh, yeah, the
wrap
whole point
up
of the
Sam's Top 5 right after this.
Me, but also you. The Pharaoh fast forwards his favorite foreign film. Powder donut. Okay, what's my line?
The only line I see here on the script is get options based on your budget with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive.
Oh man, that's a tongue twister, huh? I'm sorry, I'm gonna need a few more minutes.
Bulbous Walrus, the Bulbous Walrus.
The Name Your Price tool, only from Progressive.
The owl ran afoul of the comatose coxswain.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.